It's AumSum time!
Why do we have split ends?
Cause the world is coming to an end.
Nah. Split ends, or trichoptilosis, is a type of hair damage in which our hair strand or hair shaft splits into two or more branches. It mostly occurs at the end of the shaft. However, you can have split ends anywhere along the entire shaft. Now, our hair consists of three concentric layers. The outermost tough layer is called cuticle, the middle layer is called cortex, and the innermost layer is called medulla. Split ends occur when the cuticle gets ripped off or damaged. Now, as there is no longer any tough structure to hold the hair together, cracks begin to develop in the inner layers, thus giving rise to split ends. Now, there are many factors that can cause split ends. For example, excessive sun exposure, improper brushing or detangling, excessive blow drying, coloring, etc. Topic: nerves. Why don't we feel pain when we cut our hair?
Well, duh. Cause if it would, then we would have got angry on our hairdressers.
Oh, you are just impossible. Wait, I will explain it to you. Inside our body, there's a network of nerves. These nerves help us to sense our surroundings and feel pain, touch, etc., by sending messages to the brain.
So do the nerves of my hair not know how to send a message?
No.
Huh?
Generally, the part of our hair above the skin is made up of dead cells. It does not have any nerves. Hence, when we cut our hair, due to the absence of nerves, our brain does not receive any messages of pain. As a result, we don't feel any pain. Topic: dandruff. Why do we get dandruff?
Tearing of pages.
Nah. Huh? Dandruff is a condition in which our scalp sheds skin cells in the form of white flakes. A yeast called Malassezia globosa is one of the mostly accepted reasons for causing dandruff.
Wow! What a classy name it has.
Indeed. Malassezia globosa is naturally present on our scalp.
Huh?
It feeds on sebum and releases oleic acid. Now, some people are sensitive to this oleic acid. When it penetrates the upper layers of their skin, it causes inflammation. Hence, in response to this inflammation, their skin sheds a large number of skin cells at a higher rate. These cells then join together forming white flakes, thus causing dandruff. Topic: human hair. Why do we get white hair?
Because we cannot get blue hair.
No. Our hair is basically made up of keratin, a colorless protein. Hence, before our hair comes out of the skin, it is almost white.
How's that possible? I had black hair during childhood.
Don't worry, I'll explain. Our hair grows from hair follicles. A hair follicle contains melanocytes, which produce melanin. Melanin is injected in the keratin cells during the growth of our hair. This melanin gives color to our hair. Now, the color of our hair is dependent on the type of melanin injected. Eumelanin makes our hair black or brown, while pheomelanin makes our hair red or blonde. However, as we grow old, the melanocytes decrease the production of melanin. Thus, less melanin is injected in hair, causing them to eventually turn white.